Hello guys, good evening. And Marlon, hello, good evening. How are you doing, man?
Good evening, teacher. I'm fine, thank you.
Fine, okay. That's good to know. How was your day? Difficult, easy, normal?
It was dynamic.
Dynamic, really? Okay.
Yeah.
And so, how? Tell me.
I feel a little bit tired. Say, say, say.
Yeah, yep. A little bit tired. Yeah. Okay. What is the most difficult? Well, what is the most tiring day? El día más cansado. What's the most tiring day?
It depends. It depends if I have some projects in execution. Proyectos en ejecución.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
So it depends about the situation.
Okay, that's good.
For example, last time we have a project in Plaza Mundo Popa, and as you know, Plaza Mundo Popa is a big mall.
Yeah. And demanding because there are a lot of
but
people.
It was when the mall was in construction.
Okay.
And so I had to walk every day.
Distances and yes,
long distances. Yes.
Okay. Yes, I think there are like seasons, como temporadas. There are some seasons that maybe for you are harder, son más difíciles, right? So that happens. That's because that's the nature of your job, right? It is not all the jobs. Or the occupation that depends on you. Okay, so that's good to know. Okay, thank you, Marlon.
Thank you.
And here we have Dianita. Hello, ¿qué te me habías hecho? Tell me.
Hi. Es que estaba enferma.
Ah, really? And now you are better. Ya te sientes mejor.
Yes.
Ya curada.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Well, it's good to know. And tell me, how was your vacation or weekend, right? You had like free weekend on Saturday, relaxing time? No.
Me tocó trabajar.
Yes, you worked.
Mm-hmm.
You worked. Oh, I'm sorry. So you didn't go out on Sunday? Go out.
Ya la descansé.
Ah, okay, resting. Resting.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Good, Anita. Thank you. Thank you for telling me. We have also Susie. Hello, Susie.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. How are you tonight? Tell me.
A little better. A little better.
Okay. That's good to know. It's good to know. And tell me, you didn't have vacations, right? No vacations. Okay.
No, solo viernes y domingo.
Only just Friday and Sunday.
Yep.
Okay. Did you do something special? Anything out of common? Fuera de lo común?
No, nada.
No, nothing.
Solo trabajar, por lo menos normal, sí. El día que descansé, solo visitar la suegra, pero nada más.
Oh, okay. Good. Good. That's fine. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Susie. Merci. Hello, Mercy.
Hello, teacher. Good night.
Hello, Mercy. What day is the hardest for you? ¿Cuál es el día más duro para ti?
Monday.
Monday? Do you think Mondays are difficult? Yes.
Today, weekend, bueno, toda la semana.
Okay, I know that during the weekend, but there are, as we were talking with Marlon, there are some seasons or some periods of time in which the work or our job is more difficult. ¿Verdad? Hay etapas como más difíciles. So that happens. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Mercy. Diego, hello, my friend. Don't cry. She loves you. Yeah.
Hey, hi, teacher. Good evening.
Okay. Good evening. How was your day? Tell me.
Bye. Things have been a little bit rough lately, but they're getting better now.
Okay. Well, I can imagine that. What's the most difficult day for you during the week?
All days
all days are the same. Okay.
Yeah, today was a particular day because I didn't work, but I was a lot of things to do outside, you know.
You took advantage of your day, of this day.
Yes.
And that's tiring as well.
Took advantage.
It is tiring to go outside and do a lot of things, maybe going to the bank. Or doing different things that normally you don't do because you're working. So, okay, I can understand.
Yeah, okay. It was a hard day.
Okay, well, so when we finish the class, you go to bed as soon as possible.
Yeah, I will go straight to my bed.
Definitely. Okay, Diego, thanks. Then here we have Dorita. Hello. Mm-hmm.
Hello. Good evening.
How? Well, tell me about your vacations.
I'm fine.
Okay. Did you have vacations? ¿Tuviste vacaciones?
Yes.
How many days?
3.
3 days. Okay. And three what days. Did you do? Okay,
visit.
Visit
family.
Okay, this is your family. Where? Donde?
San Miguel.
Okay. Are you from San Miguel? Eres de San Miguel? No.
Mi esposo.
Ah, your husband?
Yes.
Okay. What about iguanas? Do you like iguanas? Tenga arroz, because when I have visited San Miguel, I can see a lot of people like selling those kind of animals. Do you like them? ¿Te gusta?
No,
not at all. Okay.
No.
Okay, there's people that they like iguana in El Guayse or something like that. I don't know. Well, strange tastes. Okay, good. Thank you, Dorita. Carmen. Okay, now you look like a working woman, no vacation woman, no relaxing. Okay, now like a hard working woman.
Good evening.
Good evening. Pues sí, ¿cómo estuvo ahora? How was your day?
A hard day.
A hard day.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. And we have like what? 3 days and we are on Friday. We are almost to finish this class. So that's it. Do you have like special plans for this week? Para esta semana? ¿Planes especiales?
Meeting, projects to review.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Work.
As always, work. More work and more work.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Okay, thank you, Carmen. Andreita, tell me. How was your day? ¿Cómo estuvo tu día?
Perfect.
No problem.
Yeah. No.
Okay. Well, that sounds like very good. No problem. Hey, thank you, Andreita. Claudia. Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How are you tonight? Tell me.
Very good day.
Oh, well. You had a very good day, okay? I like that. Remember me, Claudia? What's your occupation? What do you do? What's your occupation, Claudia? What do you do?
I am assistant administrative.
Okay, and you consider, what is the most difficult day during the week for you? It's Monday, it's Tuesday, Friday.
Monday.
Everybody, well, normally a lot of people hate that Monday. Okay, thank you. And we have Claudita. Hello.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
How are you tonight?
Good.
Fantastic.
We're fantastic. Okay, that's good. Thank you. Okay, Carla, how are you tonight?
Hi, teacher.
Hello. How are you? Good? Fine?
Cool.
Good. Cool. Okay. Okay. I like to hear that. Nice. Perfect. Here we have also Helen, that she's hiding. Se me está escondiendo Helen. Edgar and Alexander Bogram. Hello, Christian, Alexander. No, Edgar Chacón. Yes, Edgar Chacón, hello, que parecía como Alexander. Okay. Hello, Edgar. How are you, my friend? Did you do anything special on vacations? ¿Hiciste algo especial en vacaciones? Or the previous days, the last days?
Yesterday, my family.
Ah, really? Okay. You spend time with your family. Okay, good. Did you go to any place? Any special place? No. No, at home.
At home.
Okay, that's good. That's perfect. It's good to spend time with the family. I always say that. Okay, we're going to study tonight simple present and negative sentences. That is something that is pretty easy. No, I consider that you don't have any problem with this. We are on class number 4. So we're going to start with this question. That is the first speaking activity. The question is, how are businesses today different from 50 years ago? ¿Qué tan diferentes son los negocios de ahora a comparación de 50 años? What are the differences? Do you consider they are the same? There are advantages, disadvantages, hay ventajas, desventajas, or there are, well, there are like the nature of the businesses, la naturaleza de los negocios. So to start with this, well, before starting with this, I'm going to check the attendance list so you can have, or you can be ready with your answers. But first, let's listen to Ana Mercedes Amaya. Hello. Say present.
Hello, okay. Present.
Thank you, Mercy. Andrea, Rita.
Good evening.
Good evening, thank you. Carmen.
I'm here.
It's fine. Claudia Diaz.
Present.
Okay, that's good. Claudita.
Present.
Fine. Cristian Castellanos, I think he's not here by now, but here we have Cristian Bogram. Hello.
Present.
Hello, my friend. How have you been? ¿Cómo has estado?
More or less.
More or less. Okay, later we're going to talk about it, okay? And thank you. Dianita.
Present.
Nice. Diego Garcia.
Present, sir.
That's good. Thank you. Dorita.
Present.
Fine. Edgar Chacon, I saw you over there, Edgar.
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you. You're there. Helen Barraza.
Present.
Okay, yes. Thank you, Helen. Jose Miguel, no. Carla. Hello, Carla.
Present.
Thank you. Well, Kevin is not here with us. I'm sorry for him. Kevin.
Present.
Thank you, Kevin. Leslie is not here. Marlon. Hello, Marlon.
Hello, present.
Thank you. Susana Jimenez.
Present, teacher.
Good. And Veronica. We don't have Veronica either tonight. Okay. How are businesses today different from 50 years ago? Okay, let's listen to Andrea. I think Andrea has a lot to say with this question, right, Andreita? Tell me or tell us.
Now you can, now?
Mm-hmm. Andrea, sorry. The sound is, well, it's different. Un poco diferente. The headphones are the same. Son los mismos audífonos.
Sí, son los mismos, pero no me tenía problemas para conectarme. Pero no sé, ahora veo todo bien diferente, no sé por qué.
Ajá, and I think the internet is different, like, it is slower, como que más lento el internet. or not? Are you having problems with the internet or with the platform? ¿Con la plataforma o el internet?
Ajá, la plataforma debe estar rara porque no me aparece así. Incluso para verlo a usted me aparecía todo raro. No sé, quizás después voy a ver qué le pasa.
Ok, gracias, Andreita, pero bueno, así soy. No, lo que pasa es que quizás si estás en computadora, necesitas actualizarla. ¿Estás en la PC? ¿Are you on?
Sí.
A veces se necesita, porque a mí ayer me llegó la actualización.
Es que me pedía, posible. Al principio para conectarme, me pedía que buscara en Microsoft, en el store de Microsoft. Uh-huh. Ahí que buscara un programa para poder conectarme a la reunión, algo así me decía.
Uh-huh. Qué cerrar. Bueno, ok. No, es que te escuchas como muy, como cuando tenés micrófono y está como tapado. Así, algo así.
Ay,
se escucha.
Pero está...
Ah, ok, tal vez te lo puedes acercar un poquito, please. Ok, Andrea, tell me, what are the differences? Okay.
No, you can buy and pay from a smartphone or computer. After existed the Colón, before all was more cheap.
Okay, yeah, now you can buy by using a cell phone and the coin or the current, la moneda, ¿verdad? La moneda was different. It was the Colón, right? I think the Colón
sí,
has... Yeah, well, yes, yes, yes. It's cheaper. Did you use Colón? ¿Utilizaste el Colón?
Sí. Lo recuerdo. No.
Really? I did. Yes, I did. Yo lo usé. Okay.
Well,
yes. Okay. Thank you, Andrea. What about Carmen? Do you have any idea?
Yeah. 50 years ago, it was still common to send correspondence between departments on paper. Then email came.
Okay, yes. And even there was a document called Telegrama. If you, I don't know if you remember that, but the Telegrama was a letter that you could write on Antel. I think it was Antel. And it, imagine a letter. Imagínense una carta. And you you used to write words. And then the person in charge, he or she has to count the words. Contaba las palabras. And based on the number of the words, you have to pay. Tú pagabas en base a las palabras que escribías. Okay. I don't know if maybe, I don't know if any other person or any other people remembers, but. Sí, yo creo que sí.
And the other idea, all the tax of the companies are carried out in the same complex, en el mismo lugar. The teleworking was not
possible.
Uh-huh.
Yes, yes, yes. And now it's part of the reality. And 50 years ago, it looked like, do you remember the Jetson, los supersónicos? They had like that kind of video conference, and we used to see that and say, well, maybe that may happen, but in the future, far away. Okay. So thank you, Karen. Good for you. Okay. What about Claudita?
Hi.
Hi.
Today they have more technology, and the phones, and the lo que decía Carmen que tenía los emails.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. It was different. Yes. Okay. Uh-huh. Good. Thank you, Claudita. What about Diego? Tell me, Diego, and then Mercy.
Okay. I think that. The main reason why businesses are different today is because every day new products, new services are born. And this is because the human being every day is creating or inviting new needs. And this is the reason why businesses are different, because 15 years ago, doesn't exist stuff like internet or cell phones, and this is part of the change, actually, or sorry, currently. And for the other hand, today are a lot of ways to pay, for example, platforms like PayPal. This is the reason why the businesses are different.
Yeah.
And today también the companies are taking advantage from the social media to promote services, products, and I don't know. This is what I think.
Yes, of course. And that's part of the innovations that the enterprises have. They are always creating.
But I don't know if you can you hear me?
Yes, yes, of course. Yes, I can hear you clearly. Mm-hmm. So that's it, that's part. And as you mentioned, yeah, the enterprises are always innovating, creating a lot of products and needs based on the marketing, of course. So that's it. Yes, and social media,
exactly.
Social media plays like a big role nowadays, because you can find on Instagram, on Facebook, or any different social media, you can find different forms to buy. So that's it. Yeah, they are taking advantage. The enterprises are taking advantage of the social media. So thank you, Diego.
Yes, exactly. That's wonderful. That's my point.
Of course it is. Thanks for sharing.
You're merci. Welcome.
Merci. And then we go with Helen.
Okay. Before, there were no machines to replace employees. Before, no exist social media to advertise the business.
Okay, yes. Nowadays, we have machines replacing people's job, and also the social media. Yes. Didn't exist. Well, at least in comparison to now. So thank you, Mercy. What about Helen? And then we go with Claudia.
Hola.
Hello.
Hello. Company, they have technology. Technology of today, company, Wi-Fi, transport de antes, me imagino que era.
Yeah, different. Yes, transportation, of course.
Tape writer, máquina de escribir.
Typing machine. Sí. Yes, of course. The contometer, el contómetro, and even the
aún se usa.
Yes, even the counters, they use it because it's an important tool. But talking about the transportation nowadays, you can find different products from China, and the shipping payment, el pago por el envío. Sometimes it is not so high, no es tan alto in comparison to the past. Okay, now you can buy from, or you can use AliExpress, eBay. You can buy in Alibaba and different apps or platforms, and you can see, pueden ver, you can see the shipping payment. It is not so high, no es tan alto el pago del envío. Okay, so thank you, Helen. Of course it is. Claudia, and then we go with okay, Claudia, and then Dorita.
Okay, before there were only buses and taxis as the most common means of transport. Now there are more applications, for example, as Uber and Driver.
Yes. So, yes, that's part of the businesses. The before you could take a taxi, now you ask for an Uber, or there are different forms, right? Not only to transport yourself, but also to ask for food, ¿verdad? Pedir comida. Have the different también. Forms. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Of course. Okay. Thank you, Claudia. Dorita, and then we go with Edgar.
It's very different. Today is bought and sold online.
Yes, you can buy online. And even you can sell. You can find in the marketplace in Facebook, right? On Facebook, I'm sorry. You can find different articles, new or used. And it is easier. Now, es más fácil, it is easier, right? And it is not necessary to have like a specific place, okay? You can buy online as well. Okay, thank you, Dorita. Edgar, and then we go with Susana.
And the businesses are now more dependent on technology. Before, everything was more manual. Ya podríamos ver la computadora, ¿verdad? Que ahora es reemplazada por, no al revés, la máquina de escribir es reemplazada por la computadora. Yes. Podría ser Excel, la mayoría de los contadores, todo era puro
cuaderno. By hand, by ahora, hand, yes. By using books, a lot of books. Mm-hmm. Now they have different programs, okay, to register buying. Okay, and you said an important word, dependent. Now the enterprises or all the businesses are dependent on technology, of course. So thank you. We go now with Susie, then Alex Bogra.
Well, I think that the one of the differences is the modern technology in each company. In addition, the salary and benefit that have been improving little by little, in addition to the treatment of their employees.
Okay, okay, thank you, Susie. Yes, yes. Well, the salary now, they're different. I consider that that's part of the contradiction, because even if you earn like $500 or $400 in the past, that was a lot of money. Eso era mucho dinero. But nowadays, the bills, las cuentas, yes, the clothing, la ropa, or the gasoline, well, they require more money. So that's it. But yes, we have had like improving facts, hechos de mejoría. Okay. What about Alex Bogram and then Dianita?
Okay. There was not much technology. For example, you could not receive only class.
Yes, yes, and that's part, of course, Alex. Yes, and that's part of the business. English classes or different type of classes, university classes. Yes, of course, part of the technology. Denita and then Carla.
Okay, I think they are different because 50 years ago, there were no online businesses and internet purchases.
Internet purchasing, yes, and that's for sure. Imagine now that if we wouldn't have like internet, our life would be or could become like very complicated, of course, because we're accustomed. Just ya nos acostumbramos. We're accustomed to do things like faster, easier. Okay, so that's it. Carla, and then we go with Kevin.
Hi. The difference from 50 years ago is that we are up to that. ¿Cómo se dice? Actualizar.
Updated.
And computers.
Okay. Related to computation, yes. And now the systems of the banks. Even if you go to any kind of bank, they ask you for your ID. Le piden el DUI, right? The DUI. And we have like different processes, right? And that's it. Now you can pay not only articles, but also the university. You can pay bills, los recibos. You can pay different kind of those things, okay? So thank you, Carla. What about Kevin and then Christian?
Okay, I think it is very different. An example, maybe if you want to sell something, you don't need to offer it or show it in person. Since on the internet, you have the facility to do it faster.
Yes. For example, if you want to sell something on the marketplace, you just show pictures or videos, right? And you establish the price, establece el precio, and that's it, okay? And you don't have to do it personally, okay? Thank you, Kevin. Good. And Christian.
Sería, there are new ways to promote products. Mm-hmm. With digital platform.
Yes. Yes, platform. Platform. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so thank you. What about Marlon?
I agree with all my friends in all the points that they have talked. I think the time is different now than that 50 years ago. And we have different technologies, more advanced technology. We have different transportation ways. We have different or we have advanced roads, advanced roads. Mm-hmm. Advanced. Carreteras avanzadas, mm-hmm. Que antes eran caminos empedrados.
Yes,
tierra.
Yes, of course.
So we are in different times, mm-hmm. And so we have to advance in all the ways, and in the communication ways, in the transportation ways, and in the way to live.
Of course,
we have to be in a progressive, in a constant progressive, en un progreso constante, así mm-hmm. se dice.
Yes, progress. Constant progress.
Constant progress. So I think that's the my point of view about.
Of course.
About that.
Yes. I completely agree. And as you said, we have been moving on, improving, and now we are advancing in different aspects. Imagine 50 years ago. Nobody knew about Netflix or watching movies at home, right? I think you do remember, ustedes si se acuerdan, when we used to buy DVDs, movies, they were expensive. They were like $5, $4, and then three.
VHS era.
Yes. VCR, of course. I use that. Yes, VHS, VCRs. And that's it. And we have like Blockbusters, we have some other video renting similar to Blockbuster. So nowadays it is completely different. So thank you for all your answers. I think you have participated. So thank you. Yes, I always love to listen to your opinions because all of your ideas are important for me. So thank you. Expressing wishes. I like these phrases because they are very common. Wishes is deseos, pero no deseo de embarazada. No, wishes is when you want to wish something happen, cuando quieren que pase algo. Para expresar deseos, se usa I wish, se utiliza el I y el verbo en pasado. Esa es la manera. Por ejemplo, imagine you are walking on the street, down the street, and suddenly you find a lamp, a genie lamp, so you can rub it, and then a genie appears. Genie significa genio. Genius significa genio, but a brilliant person, a smart person, but genie es como genio, ¿verdad? Como el de Aladdin. So if you have like one wish or three wishes, what would you wish? ¿Qué desearían? En este caso, podemos decirlo de esta manera. I wish I had three dogs. ¿Qué significa me gustaría o deseo tener? Deseo tener. No se dice I wish I have. ¿Ok? Se dice I wish I had. El verbo es en pasado. I wish I had three dogs. I wish I had $1,000,000. I wish I had... What? Five wives? Cinco esposas? I don't know. So in that part, in the other part we have, I wish I were. Eso es desearía ser. Se dice, I wish I were. Aunque el pasado de am, obviamente, es was. Por lógica sería, I wish I was, pero no se dice así. Se dice, I wish I were an actor. I wish I were Lionel Messi. I wish I were... who? Maradona. No, Maradona is dead. No. I wish I were the president of the United States. I wish I were Donald Trump. I don't know. You can do... you can ask for different wishes. Pueden pedir diferentes deseos. Así que creo que piensen en un deseo. Cualquier deseo. Me gustaría cumplírselos. But you can say, I wish I had. Me gustaría tener. Si quieren decir, me gustaría ver... Ver se dice sí, pero como es un verbo irregular en pasado es so. I wish I saw Mars, el planeta Marte, ¿ok? Mars planet, ¿ok? So, any verb, cualquier verbo que van a utilizar acá es en pasado. Me gustaría comer, no se dice I wish I eat. Se dice I wish I ate. I wish I ate the biggest pizza in the world. La pizza más grande en el mundo. I don't know. You can ask for different wishes. Okay.
So, teacher, sorry, I had a question.
Yeah, tell me.
It's about the verb to be in the third person. I wish I were. It's a rule or something like that about it.
Yes.
It's only in that case.
That applies for everything. Aplica para todos, el where. I wish she were an actress. I wish Carla were like a model. I wish Dora were a queen. Entonces el where aplica para todo. Hay una canción, I really like, I love that song, que es Wishlist, de Pearl Jam. Hay una canción así se llama, de Pearl Jam, que se llama Wishlist. Y allí, el brother dice, I wish I was, toda la canción dice, I wish I was an alien, I wish I was a radio song, y así. Pero ese es un inglés bien informal, como cuando decimos, okay. Es he doesn't, ¿verdad? Pero hay unas canciones que dicen he don't. Ya las he escuchado, ¿eh? So that's it. But like the formal, like grammatically correct. It's the correct word. Oh, la canción, the song, the Pink Floyd song, I wish you were here. Or like Incubus, I wish you were here. It's totally different, of course, but the name of the song is the same. So,
okay. Yeah, I asked you because I knew that in first person, we should use was.
Was, yes. You can use it, but it is kind of informal. Like I mentioned that song that I really love. Pueden buscarle esa canción que me gusta bastante. Solo en esa canción solo pasa pidiendo deseos. Se llama Wishlist, and I'm sorry, wish. It is así. I wish I was, but even the correct form is I wish I were, but it's part of that. It's part of that.
Okay.
That the idea that he wants to convey. So tell me, tell me your wishes. A ver, vamos a escuchar un par de deseos. Marlon, tell me your first wish. And then, Dianita.
Of course, I wish I visited Europe.
Okay, of course. Why not, Dianita? And then,
I wish I visited Japan.
Japan. Mm. ¿Te vas a conseguir un chinito?
Japan, no.
Okay. Diego, then Kevin.
Okay, I don't know. I wish to have a lot of money.
Yeah. How much money?
I don't know how much. Maybe
10 million, 1 billion.
1 billion.
Yeah, 1 billion. Yeah, okay. Alcance. Okay, good for you. Kevin and Dorita.
I wish a very big car.
Okay. Dorita, then Carla.
I wish I ate fish.
Okay. Okay, that's a good question. Carla, then Alex Bogran.
Teacher, como dijo que se era ver.
So, como la película So.
Okay. Oh, todavía no la tengo.
Okay, I'm going to give you time. Alex, and then Susie.
I wish I were a doctor.
Okay, good. Susie, then Christian.
I wish I had $1 million.
One, why not 2 million? 3 million.
Only one.
Okay, Christian, and then we go with Mercy.
I wish I have superpowers.
Superpowers. Okay, what? Do you have any specific superpower? Or all of them? Todos? Or one or two superpowers?
Todos.
All of them. Le quiere ganar a Marvel, ya dice. Okay, good. That's fine. Mercy, then Carmen.
I wish to go to Paris.
I went Paris. Okay, qué romántica, Mercy. Carmen, then Claudia.
I wish I had $2 million.
Oh, okay, $2 million. Le vamos a quitar dos a Diego. Okay, two from Diego's money for you. Okay, Claudia, then Helen.
I wish I had a visa to travel around the world.
to travel around the world.
Travel. Yes.
Good. Okay. And Helen, then Andreita.
I wish money.
I wish I had money. Okay. ¿Cuánto? A Diego le vamos a quitar toda su pista. Okay. How many millions? ¿Cuántos millones? Hablemos de millones. Okay. Let's talk about millions. Four. Three. Okay.
Three.
Ya le vamos quitando como 4 millones. Okay, Andreita, then Claudita. Tell me.
Teacher, el verbo conocer.
Ay, sí, mira, ya se escucha la voz sexy del locutor. Okay.
Es que se me había desinstalado Zoom. Entonces ya estaba directo del internet, de la página de Zoom.
Ya. Okay. No es conocer. Ajá. New, como nuevo en pasado, como esto, así se pronuncia. Ajá, new. I wish I knew
Chris Hemsworth.
Picar a mesa lista. Okay. Good. And Claudia, Teodita, and then Edgar.
I wish I knew Howard Castle.
Howard Castle. Ay, pensé que una persona. Okay, Howard Castle. Okay. Me salió Sanita. And we have Edgar, right?
I wish I had infinity billions.
Okay, good for you. Yeah, I think you can do a lot of things with that quantity of money. Okay, Carla? Carla?
I wish I saw the beach.
The beach, okay, of course. Okay, now here we have a joke. Tenemos un chiste. And this is about wishes, aparte de deseos. It says like that. Three guys standing on a desert island. Fine, a magic lantern containing a genie. Estaban tres tipos, ¿verdad? Una isla y encuentran casualmente a magic lantern containing a genie who grants them each one wish. Le da un deseo. The first guy wishes. El primero desea. He was off the island and back home. Deseo irse fuera de la isla a casa. The second guy wishes the same. So, three guys, one to home, the other one to home. The third guy, tercero, says, I'm lonely. Soy solitario. I wish my friends were back here. Desearía que mis amigos estuvieran de nuevo acá. So, can you see I wish my friends were. Entonces, aquí ustedes pueden utilizar, en lugar de friends, pueden utilizar Carmen, Diego, Dora, and all those things. Okay. So, here you have travels. I'm going to give you, for the next activity, 5 seconds. Okay. Try to memorize as many words as possible. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's see, what about Marlon? Any word?
Junior sales manager.
Okay, fine. And what about Andrea?
Call potential clients.
Mm-hmm. Helen. No te me escondas, Helen. No te agarren curva ahora. Helen.
Ah. No, no me acuerdo.
Se te fue el avión. Ok, Diana, then Claudia.
Clients,
ok. Claudia, then Mercy.
Being a magic.
Mm-hmm. Ok. Mercy, then Carmen.
Ok, yo, duties.
Mm-hmm. Carmen, then Edgar.
Esa tenía yo.
Mm-hmm. La vieja confiable.
Mm-hmm. Yo, title, no sé cómo se dice.
Title, ok. Edgar, then Diego.
Decía, congratulations, are you know, no sé qué más decía.
Ok, ok, thanks. Diego, then Kevin.
Okay, have a meeting with your manager every week.
Okay, mm-hmm. Have a meeting. Nice. Kevin, then Susie.
Welcome to Travelers Inc.
Mm-hmm. Fine. Susie, then Alex.
Answer client's question.
Mm-hmm. Fine. Alex, then Christian.
Getting contact with customer.
Okay, good. Christian, Carla.
Sería have a meeting with your manager.
Mm-hmm. Okay, nice. And we have Carla.
Okay,
thank you. I need you to help me reading. Okay, Traverse Inc. For a very future, dear employee. Mm-hmm. Querido empleado. Okay, and help me please, Edgar, with number one. I need you to read this line and this line, please.
Okay, welcome to Traverse Inc. Congratulations. Mm-hmm. You are now part of the Travers family.
Okay, thank you. Común, ¿verdad? Que nos llamen familia en las empresas. Okay. Carmen, here's some, this one and this one.
Here's some information about your new job. Mm-hmm. Please read it carefully.
Mm-hmm. Carefully. Mm-hmm. Claudita, this and this.
Okay. Name, Glenda Dominic Sanchez.
Mm-hmm. Job.
Job little.
Title. Mm-hmm.
¿Cómo?
Title. Pueden decir title, pero lo más común es title, con R, title.
Okay, job title. Junior sales manager.
Sales manager. Okay, thank you. Okay, and now here we have K job duties. Okay, the duties son los deberes. Have a meeting. Okay, so Helen, please help me with this. Have a meeting.
Have a meeting with your manager every week.
Mm-hmm. Eso es lo que tienen que hacer, tener reunión mm-hmm. con el jefe cada semana. Okay, Susie, get, and then Christian.
Get in contact with customers.
Mm-hmm. Christian, and then we go Alex.
Answers clients' question about our product.
Mm-hmm. About our product, okay. Answer, aquí es answer. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Alex. And then we go with Dianita.
They order on the telephone.
Telephone, okay. Diana, and then Andrea.
Call potential clients.
Mm-hmm. Good. Andrea, then Diego. I can hear you, Andrea.
Excuse me.
No problem.
Vacations, 2 weeks per year.
Plus
public holidays.
Public holidays. Okay. That was not that bad. No se tan bueno. Okay. Diego, and we finish with Kevin.
Okay. Salary. 440 per month plus bonus.
Okay, good. And Kevin?
Good luck, Mark Travers, CFO.
Okay, thank you. Marlon, help me with this. Read the sentences, say if they are true or false. We're going to say if it is true or false. So vamos a decir si es verdadero o falso. Okay, so number one, Marlon, please help me.
Dominic speaks to clients in her new job.
Do you consider it is true or false, Marlon?
It's true.
Yes, of course it is. Okay, what about Mercy, number two? And Diana, number three.
Her salary is 100
$100 per week. Mm-hmm.
False?
It is false, yes, because for $140. Okay, thank you. And Anita here, number three. And for number four, we have Carmen.
Dominic gets a yearly vacation.
Mm-hmm.
Is false?
Yes, it is false because she has a public holidays plus 2 weeks per year. Nice. And Carmen?
She has to work on holidays.
Do you consider it is true? Is it false? True? False, of course. Falso, como el amor de ya saben. Okay, we have conversations here. So please take like 6 seconds. Helen, te voy a preguntar de primero. 6 seconds, 6 segundos. Okay. Okay, Helen, then Diana, que está rezando. Okay, Helen.
How many with do you?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, nice. Diana, then Kevin.
Más o menos me acuerdo, decía...
Dale, lo que te salga del cora.
Ay, Dios. O sea, que él trabajaba 5 días a la semana.
De verdad.
Ay, sí, algo así decía.
Ok, así decía.
Pero no me acuerdo.
Pues acuérdese. Ok, Kevin, then Edgar.
Yo no me fijé.
Qué bárbaro, qué bárbaro. Ok, Kevin, se te fue el avión, mira, se te fue la costa. No cortaste la vara. Ok, where is Edgar then Marlon?
Teacher.
Yo diré, sí, vaya. Miren que se les está yendo. Bueno, Buxo. Marlon, and then Claudia.
I see.
¿No?
De eso me acuerdo. Ay, sí.
Ah, ay, sí, ok.
Era la penúltima oración.
Ok, bueno, te creo, hombre. Ok, Claudia, then we go with Andrea. Te lo veo preocupada, Andrea.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, good. And Andrea and Dora.
Extra hour.
Extra hours. Creo que la está inventando, creo. Okay, Dorita and Carmen.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Me gusta cómo se escuchó eso. Carmen and Diego.
Yes, work extra hours.
Qué bárbara. Come on. Okay. Diego then Susie.
I see. Well, sometimes there's not much time.
Mm-hmm. Well, wonderful. And Susie, then Christian.
That's great.
Sorry?
That's great.
That's great. Great.
Great. Sorry. Great.
Okay. Okay. Christian.
Sometimes on Saturday.
Sometimes on Saturday. Good. Carla, do you have one word? And Mercy?
Ay, solo leí ya no pude leer más.
Qué bárbara. Okay. Thank you. Mercy and Alex.
I see where.
Todas están copiado eso. Alex. Ajá, pues sí.
Sometime on Saturday.
Okay, good. Nice. Que tienen que ver lo que los demás no ven. Tienen que ver con los ojos del corazón, como decía el principito. Ustedes algo tienen. Okay, so we have a conversation between Ben Affleck and Jeff Hammett. Okay, we have Ben and Jeff. And I need you to help me. Well, first, tell me if you find a difficult word. Don't be ashamed, no tengan pena, tell me. Because you're going to help me reading this. Okay, scanning. Vamos a escanear. No problem with this. Many, no, doing, great, una palabra que digo bastante, great. Sometimes. Hours, how much, money, como la canción de Pink Floyd, extra hours, I don't tell. Okay, you don't have problems with this. Okay, Carmen, help me. You're going to be Ben and Claudita, Jeff. Go ahead.
Jeff, how are you doing? I want to ask you how many days a week do you work?
Mm-hmm. Hey, Ben. Well, I work 5 days a week. And you?
Thank you. Kevin, you are Ben, the second Ben. And Diana, you are Jeff.
And then they say
That's great.
I work 4 weekdays and sometimes on Saturdays.
Okay, sometimes. Yes, sometimes on Saturday. Okay, Diana.
Really? On Saturday, do you work extra hours? And how much money do they pay for each extra
hour? Yes, extra hour.
And how much money do they pay for
Dianita, has tomado ahora. Are you okay, Diana? I think you have some tequila for your sore throat, maybe. You have like 3 shots. No? No, digo porque pueden traer del trabajo. So. Okay, no problem, Dianita. Okay, how much money do they pay for each extra hour? Okay, Marlon, help me please, my friend. Yes. Ya que Dianita está indispuesta.
Yes, I work extra hours when there is too much work to do. Each extra hour is around $10.
$10, okay. Dorita, I see. Well,
I see. Well, sometimes there.
Okay, I think the connection failed. Creo que la conexión falló. Dorita.
I see. Well,
sometimes there is not much time, right?
Mm-hmm. There is not much time, right? Y aquí decimos esta palabra que me la va a decir Carla. A ver, Carla, ¿cómo decimos esto?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's it. Okay, we're going, please, I need you to have a screenshot. Please, and we're going to practice this conversation, and then we are having another speaking activity. So please, we're going to practice this conversation. And in this case, I'm going to create the pairs. Voy a crear las parejas, ¿verdad? So you can have different kinds of accents or pronunciation. During this time, you can practice by your own. Pueden practicar ustedes mismos, ¿verdad? Ya comenzamos. Okay, see you in a couple of seconds. Well, a couple of minutes. Claudia, everything okay? ¿Todo bien, Claudia? Claudita, vamos a esperar un rato, ¿viste? Hola.
Hola.
Sí, solo practica un momento. Vamos a ver, porque aquí tiene que estar la otra compañera. Dame 10 segundos, 15.
Ok, ok.
Hello, Claudita.
Hello, teacher.
Démosle, ¿oíste?
Ya no quiso.
¿Quién no quiso? ¿Quién vos?
No sé quién fue mi compañera.
Ah, aquí está, espérate. Ya va a aparecer aquí esta mujer. Te tienen miedo.
Ay, ajá.
Ok, démosle nosotros, ¿ok?
Ok.
Bien, igual. Ok. Yo comienzo. Ah, no, ya vino acá.
Ah, la toca ya.
Ah, Claudia. Te estaban regañando.
Lo siento, se me cerró y me costó entrar.
Mira, se ha portado mal. Yo creo que te has portado mal. Bueno, denle con todo.
No.
Ok.
Do there extra hours?
Yes.
Each extra hour is around $10.
I see. Well, sometimes there is not much time, right?
Absolutely.
Hello. ¿Cómo lo hizo Marlon? ¿Cómo lo hizo Dianita?
Excelente.
Ya le dije que no soy ebria.
No, yo no dije eso.
Así dijo.
No, dije que tal vez habías tomado algo para la garganta.
No.
Va, Marlon.
Sí, no por gusto apagó la cámara, ¿verdad?
No, si ahorita está otra vez. Está sirviendo no. Hacia el otro. Dale.
No, qué malo.
Hay que oír la risa. No, ya me voy de aquí. Me van a dar ganas. Goodbye.
Bye.
Around $10.
I see. Well, sometimes there is not much time, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. Hello. You finish? Everything okay?
Yes.
Todo bien. Tienen cara de inocente ustedes dos, aunque no lo son, pero tienen. Fine. ¡Qué rápido! Ok. Oh, ok. Uh-huh.
No tocaba salirnos todavía.
¿Cómo no? Ok, no problem. Ok, we're going to... Vamos con lo de... Mercy, no problems with the vocabulary. Andrea, no problem, right? Easy cheesy, a piece of cake. Okay, no problem. Yanita, no problem with the vocabulary, right? Everything okay?
No wonderful. Problem.
Okay, Kevin, problems with this vocabulary?
Todo bien, teacher.
Okay, everything okay. Helen, no problem with the vocabulary?
La última palabra.
Absolutely. Cuatro sílabas. Absolutely. No es okay. Telly. No es telly. Absolutely. Okay. Y acuérdense que el ly it's a suffix que significa mente, ¿verdad? Porque absolute, Dianita, ¿conoces? Absolute, ¿verdad? Es absoluto.
Yes. Yo pensé que era absolutamente.
Absolutely es absolutamente.
Ah, ok.
Bueno, yo hablaba de otro absoluto, pero está bien. Ok, so.
No es de la competencia.
Diego salió, se activó. Ok. No. Ok, well, esa risa, la risa de todos ustedes. Bueno, gente pecadora. Ok, what do you think, what's your opinion, what do you consider about plastic surgery? Is it good? Is it bad? Depends on, ¿de qué depende? Depends on what? Depends on the money, depends on the situation, depends on the health. Would you have one? So, do you agree? Ustedes me dicen, ¿están de acuerdo? I agree. I don't agree. Would you have one? ¿Tendrían una? What part of your body would you have? Okay, so that depends on if you want a modification or that's for health, si es por salud. Okay, if it is necessary or not. So we're having some opinions in this case. We're going to start with Carmencita. So tell me, Carmen, what your opinion about it?
The plastic, yes. The plastic surgeries are almost miraculous.
Well, I will not make myself one just to change something.
No. Yes. Yes or no?
No.
No, nothing. Okay. No problem. You are beautiful. You are okay. You are healthy. Eres saludable. No surgery. Okay. Te vamos a regalar uno entre todos, pero okay. No problem. Thank you, Carmencita. What about Andrea? Tell me.
I don't agree.
Oh, really? Okay.
I believe what is a problem of self-esteem. All people, mm-hmm. they should, ¿cómo era? Should?
Should.
Should love each other as they are.
Qué profunda.
I will not do one.
Okay, not for you. Ahorita te la cancelamos. Not for Andrea, not plastic surgery. Okay, thanks. For your opinion. Now we're having Dorita and then Susie. Okay, Dorita.
I will not like.
Why not? Mm-hmm. You wouldn't like. No te gustaría. Okay. No. Even for free. Ni de gratis. No.
No.
Okay, Dorita. Bye. Es un amigo que sirve. Okay. Thank you, Dorita. What about Susie? Susie, say yes. Say yes.
They can be good and bad. Good because it could be for an easy reconstruction by bone or in some part of the body. But if it causes we do not accept our body as it is, then I do not see them in a good way. Well, in the long term, it could have consequences for the person operate on.
In the future, you could have like consequences. That's your opinion as well. And
yeah.
So it is good if you need to reconstruct any part of your body, but if it is for beauty, if for appearance, you say no. So would you have one for free?
Unless necessary. No. Only necessary.
But in your case?
No.
No. Are you sure?
Yep.
Okay. You don't take advantage. No aprovecha. Okay. No, kidding. Thank you, Susie. Good opinion. Yes. I really like your words. Okay. What about Mercy and then Kevin?
Aesthetic, si es por estética, no.
For aesthetic, no. For aesthetic.
No. Mm-hmm. I think plastic surgery is just our world. Beauty. The truly beauty is in the interior and shallow, that is. Accept your beauty as you are.
Okay, accept your you think it is a matter of acceptance, okay? Wonderful. Kevin, your turn. And after Kevin, we're having Christian.
Okay. I think they have their positive contribution to people. Since some are born with bad formation in their body, and they suffer a lot of days in our bullying, and the person has the possibility to do something about it.
You said a possibility to do something about it. In the case of people, you have like different parts of your shape or your body. And yeah, there are a lot of people that they suffer from bullying. Yes, of course it is. Thanks, Kevin. A very objective opinion as well. And we have Christian. Hello there, Christian. Well, I think Christian is not able. Okay, it's not available. Edgar, what about you? Are you ready with your opinion about this?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead, my friend.
I think it is a way that person can modify some defect in him or something that he does not like.
Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe you said some defects. And I have known people that, for example, they have a different nose or the ears. Like, they look like this, like don't know, like Sabritas, it's one of my classmates. So they wanted to change that, okay? But sometimes it is a matter of, you said, of aesthetics, or you want to modify because of the beauty. Well, it's up of anyone. Okay, we're going to continue later because it is like a very interesting topic, and I know that you have, I'm sure that you have some other opinions about it. It is not necessary to be good or bad. Okay, it's a matter of opinion. Okay, it's a matter of point of view. Okay, now here we go. Figure it out. Figure it out significa resuelve. Resuelve, okay? Figure it out. Circle the word that best completes the questions. So here we have this. Yesterday we did an exercise similar to this one. So, Dorita. How much or how many hours a day do you work? ¿Qué te dice tu corazón, Dorita? Much or many?
How many?
Okay, how many hours a day do you work? Okay, good one. What about if we go with Diana? Two. How much or how many do they pay per hour?
How much do they pay per hour?
Yes. Even I don't know if in your jobs, but I consider that here in El Salvador it is more common to be or to receive payment by day than per hour, but it depends. Okay, so how many versus how much? Let's see, Diego, could you help me please, my friend? How many for countable?
Okay, how many for countable nouns? Hours, days, weeks, years, etc.
Okay, please go ahead with number one and two.
Okay, how many days a week do you rest? Mm-hmm. And how many hours a day do you work?
Okay, that's fine. Now you can see that how many it is used for referring to hours, days, weeks, and years, because you can't say one day, two days, 1 hour, 2 hours, okay? But if you talk about time, that's different, okay? How much time? Si hablan del tiempo, diferente. But in this case, we are talking about hours, days, weeks. Okay, Claudia, please. Claudia, could you help me by reading how much for uncountable?
How much for uncountable? Nouns, money, time, etc.
Okay, money, time, because son dos canciones de Pink Floyd, de hecho, ¿verdad? Si no me dejan mentir, buenísimas. Ok, please, que Claudia, number one, how much money?
Yo siempre.
Yeah, please, go ahead.
How much money do they pay per extra hour.
Good one, number two.
How much time do we have?
Okay, how much money, and how much time? Okay, thanks a lot. Now here we have worksheet, and here you have to decide, decide whether this, decide whether these nouns are countable or uncountable. So I need you to pick one of these sentences and tell us if you consider it is countable or uncountable. Of course, if you say countable, it refers to the bold letters, ¿verdad? The bold words, las palabras que están en negrita, esas son a las que se refiere, si son countable, si son contables, o si son uncountable. Okay, so be ready with this. We're going to start with Dorita. Okay, so pick one of these sentences and take your time and say if you consider it is countable or uncountable. Okay, Dorita, show time.
Number one.
Okay.
Countable.
could you read it, please? Dorita, de un solo viene con todo. Okay, could you read it, please, Dorita?
These children are playing in the garden. Mm-hmm.
The children are playing in the garden. Contable, of course. Thank you. Quiero ver. Qué bonita está haciendo. Okay, nice. Now we're going with Edgar. And then Kevin.
Number two.
Okay.
I don't like milk.
What is that? Countable or uncountable?
Uncountable.
Okay. Wonderful. Kevin, then we go with Mercy.
Teacher, en realidad yo tengo una pregunta, no puse mucha atención.
Okay. Okay, I'm going to give you time. I'm going to give you time, but okay. First, remember that countable nouns son los sustantivos que son contables, que normalmente se pueden contar así, 1, 2, 3, 4, or even you can see it, que los puedes ver, o que o al menos los puedes contar 1, 2, 3. Es bien difícil contar la arena, contar el tiempo en general, ¿verdad? O contar el aire, el agua, right? A eso nos referimos. Cuando son contables, que tú puedes decir 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Okay.
So take your time. Mercy. We go with Mercy and then with Alex.
Number 10.
Number 10.
Uncountable.
Okay. Could you read it, please, Mercy?
The bread my mother prepared is delicious.
Delicious. You say what? Countable or uncountable?
Uncountable.
El pan. El pan. Mm-hmm. Yes, how much bread? Mm-hmm. How much countable. Bread? Mm-hmm. What do you consider countable or uncountable?
Countable.
¿Puedes decir un pan, dos panes?
Yes.
Are you sure? What do you think? Okay, let's listen to Andrea and Diana.
Number 16. Mm-hmm. A rise in oil price is inevitable. Así es, inevitable.
Okay, signs, inevitable. Mm-hmm.
Inevitable signs there is more and more world demand for energy is uncountable.
Oh, I'm sorry, I was receiving a message. I'm sorry. The number, please, Andreita.
16.
Okay, we have 16. And Mercy said bread. What is bread? Como el grupo bread. 10. Okay, a rise in oil. What do you consider oil?
Uncountable.
Mm-hmm. El aceite. Bread, Mercy, is uncountable. Okay? Okay, Mercy, just for you to have an idea, a clear idea about it. Okay? Diana and Edgar.
Number 4.
Mm-hmm.
Scientists say that the environment is... Esa palabra no sé cómo se dice. Threat
es una amenaza.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Threaten, and when you say threat, amenaza. Mm-hmm. Threaten, amenazado. Okay.
Threatened by pollution.
Mm-hmm.
Is countable.
Okay. Scientists, we can say that it is countable. Who's next? No, I didn't say. Okay, what about Susie and then Diego?
Number 3, easy. I prefer tea.
No te da pena. Okay, what is that?
Uncountable.
Okay, uncountable. We go with Diego and then Claudia Diaz.
Okay, number 13. I bought 3 bottles of mineral water for our picnic.
Mm-hmm.
Mineral water
mm-hmm.
for our picnic. And this is countable.
Yes, of course, my friend. Good one. Claudia, and then we go with Carmen.
Okay, number 6.
6.
There are a lot of windows in our classroom.
In our mm-hmm. in our classroom.
In our classroom.
What
countable.
Countable. Okay, that's fine. And who's next? Carmen, then Marlon.
Five. My mother used butter to prepare cakes.
Okay.
Uncountable.
Uncountable, of course. Marlon, and then we go with Alex.
Okay, number 14. Mm-hmm. I'd like some juice, please. That's uncountable.
That's uncountable, of course. Alex, and then we go with Christian.
Seven.
Seven. Mm-hmm.
Would need some glue to fix the bus.
Base. Mm-hmm.
Base.
Well, what do you think?
Is it countable?
That is uncountable. Uncountable. Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks. And now we go with Christian and then Edgar, me parece, o Kevin.
Number eight.
Number eight.
The waiters.
Mm-hmm.
The waiter in this restaurant are very professional.
Professional.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Countable.
Thank you. Okay, I don't know who's next. If Edgar or Kevin, I just remember.
It's Kevin.
Okay. Okay, Kevin. Are you ready?
Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Go ahead.
My father points to big glasses of water every morning.
Mm-hmm.
Countable.
Okay. Nice. And Carla and Claudita.
Eleven. And must be
careful.
Comfort the roll as spring.
Slippery. Slippery. Mm-hmm. Okay. What do you think? The drivers. What is drivers? Countable or uncountable?
Uncountable.
Well, drivers or conductores. Yes, they are countable. Okay, and who's next? Who's next? And Helen, are you? Ah, Claudita, se me está escondiendo esta mujer. ¿Ya pasaste?
No, y no me estoy escondiendo.
¿Y Helen qué se me hizo? Ya está riéndose. Uh-huh.
Number
12.
Some policemen are organized road traffic to avoid an accident.
Okay, organizing road traffic. Okay, policemen. Mm-hmm.
Is countable.
Countable. And Helen, 15. Successful candidates.
Successful candidate will join the country this year.
Mm-hmm.
Become later this year.
Yes, countable or countable?
Countable.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, we continue with what do you think about plastic surgery? And we're having some opinions. And in this case, we're going to start with Marlon. Okay, my friend, your turn. Time to shine.
Okay. With the plastic surgery, I agree. But if it is about the medical situation, like, for example, like a person who has suffered an accident and needs some reconstruction of a part of her body
or face.
I think that's a good case, and I agree with that. But only in the medical cases, not if it is about vanity.
Mm-hmm. Vanity, personal decision. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes,
appearance.
And that way, I don't agree. But if it's about a medical situation, I agree.
Okay. Yeah. I think that's
perfect. I will not have
You're really only, for free.
Only if I need.
Only if I need, okay.
In a medical situation.
In a medical situation, okay. Okay. Okay, nice. We go with Dianita.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I think if they are necessary, it is okay to do them, but I am not against them.
In agreement. I am not in agreement. Okay.
In agreement.
So you wouldn't?
It depends if it's necessary, if I would.
Yeah, but okay. But in your case, would you have one?
No.
No.
No. Oh. And depends.
Depends. Imagine.
Si tuviera.
Yeah, okay, that's the point. If it were for free, imagine. Okay. Gratis, okay. Okay, thanks. Okay, to finish, we're having some other opinions. What about Helen? And then Alex.
If they are with an accident or some natural deformation,
okay.
You agree.
Mm-hmm.
Under why not?
Okay. And in your case, if imagine a free surgery, una cirugía gratis.
We're beautiful. We don't need to plastic.
No, you don't need plastic. No quieren estar como una mich. Okay. I understand your point. Alex?
In my opinion, not good.
Not good. Mm-hmm.
Can consequence in the body.
Okay. It may have consequences in the future, of course, in the future. Okay. And there are some surgeons that they don't do a very good job, and they have definitely, I don't know if Alejandra Guzman was a famous person that she has some problems with their face. They're very, they look different. They don't look natural in that case. So thank you. Okay, let's listen to Diego. And after Diego, we're having Claudia.
Okay, I think that everybody can do that. Everybody want to do with their own bodies, but mm-hmm. In fact, it's pretty nice to see all those girls with plastic surgeries. It's pretty nice to see that. You know what I mean?
Yes, I can't imagine. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, but like
donated, for example, let me see, Maribel Guardia. I think she has had a lot of plastic surgery, yeah. Because she's like 65, I guess, or 64. I don't know. Yeah, but
around,
she, yeah, she
around
looks,
65 she looks, or 66. I don't know.
Okay, so what about you? You would be well. Would you agree? In your case,
just in my case. Maybe if I need it for some medical condition or for health,
but not
why
for
not?
Pleasure or not for your own, or maybe
no, not for pleasure.
Okay, good one. Thanks.
I'm perfect.
Okay, okay, that's good to know, my friend. Hey, Claudia, tell me.
Okay, I think it's not necessary.
It is not necessary.
Each person is beautiful as God created us.
Okay, as God created us.
Only it is by some, for example, accidents, etc.
Okay.
I lie not.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you wouldn't like, no te gustaría, in your case. Okay, We go now with Christian and then Claudita.
Sería, bueno, plastic should get it only if necessary. I agree. Solo si es necesario, estoy de acuerdo. Oh, okay. De lo contrario, no.
On porque, the contrary, no.
Mm-hmm. No, for, sería for facial reconstruction by accident. No, not pleasure.
Ah, okay, not for pleasure.
For placer.
No, for pleasure. Okay, yes, not for pleasure. Okay. Okay, thanks for telling me. And Claudita?
I agree. If they have been an accident, if delivery is a need.
Mm-hmm. Would you have one? ¿Tendrías una de gratis? Que te diera una.
Ay, no, tampoco.
Okay, so
no, cuando eras persiguiendo. Nah.
Okay.
No.
No.
Me el líquido del Salvador.
No, pues sí, no, pues ahí la van a llamar a ustedes después. Okay, en Carla. Chao, mi Carla. Me relajo el gusto, ya ve.
Uh-huh. I want you to modify the appearance of the person. No, I won't not.
Okay, not to modify the appearance. Mm-hmm. The appearance of the people. Okay. So in your case, would you have one? ¿Tendrías uno?
No.
No. Okay, just say no. But maybe in the future. We don't know. Okay, we're having an activity that it is related by, well, it is for listening. Es de escuchar, y hay algo que pues les quería compartir. Sometimes when we have, for example, we have short speech. Las speech es un discurso, pero cuando es short, es bastante corto. There are some different, well, there are a variety of exams for English standards, and for instance, TOEFL or TOEIC or CASAS. And in some of these exams, that they are international ones, they have like different areas to be evaluated. Entonces, ¿cómo se evalúan diferentes áreas del inglés? Se evalúan conversaciones cortas, conversaciones largas, y también como discursos. En este caso, in this case, I'm going to present you a short speech. It is about the internet, and I need you to listen to this. And it is short. It is like, let me show you, 30 seconds. Es de 30 segundos. It's really short. But please, if you could take notes with the words that you can identify, that could be really useful. Okay. So I'm going to play it. Se lo voy a reproducir. And after that, I'm going to present the script. Le voy a presentar el guión para que ustedes también vayan escuchando. I'm going to play it twice. Lo voy a reproducir dos veces. Okay? Here we go.
Speech.
I'm sorry. Okay, now. We are ready.
Internet speech. With the help of the internet, purchasing products online has become very popular among people. All the banking and financial transactions can be sent and can receive money with the internet's help. But with all the benefits, the internet has disadvantages as well. The disadvantages include the leaking of data and personal information. Social media can also create disturbances through malicious content.
Okay, let's listen again.
Internet speech. With the help of the internet, purchasing products online has become very popular among people. All the banking and financial transactions can be sent and can receive money with the internet's help. But with all the benefits, the internet has disadvantages as well. The disadvantages include the leaking of data and personal information. Social media can also create disturbances through malicious content.
Okay, so in next classes, we're having different types of speed. And I have some friends, so they're going to send me these audios. So you can have different accents and types of pronunciation. Okay, let's listen to Diana. Do you remember any word?
Yes, personal information.
Mm-hmm. Personal information. Okay, that's a good one. What about Claudia?
Yo escuché algo como de transacción.
Mm-hmm. Okay, transaction.
De dinero, money.
Okay, okay, money. Yeah, that's good. Andrea, que te veo ahí inquieta.
Products online.
Mm-hmm. Products online. Okay, Marlon.
I hear that something that social media.
Mm-hmm. Okay, he referred to social media. Thank you. Mercy and Kevin.
Purchasing people.
Okay, purchasing people. Okay, Kevin, then Dorita.
Okay, yo solo escuché como algo de, como dijo, social media.
Okay, social media, that's good. Dorita, then Carmen.
People only.
Okay, people, good. Carmen, then Susie.
Transaction, people, help, and personal information.
Okay, good. Susie, then Edgar.
Popular people and contacts.
Okay, thanks. Edgar, then Alex.
Yeah, algo de dinero, solo dinero.
Okay, money, mm-hmm, good. Alex, then Helen.
Manager.
Mm-hmm. Helen, then Diego.
Information online. Okay. Money. People.
Thanks. Ahí te pusiste buxa, mira, Helen, ya ves. Ya te iba a dejar la costa. Thanks. Diego, then Claudita.
Okay, I heard something about pros and cons about the internet. For example, you can send and receive money and you can make purchases, but all that kind of stuff requires your personal information, and it could be a problem for you because that can be in the future a problem. And I heard about the disturbance.
Mm-hmm. That's a good word, disturbance. Yeah, that's it. Thanks, Diego. Thanks for your.
Sorry, teacher, can you hear?
Yes, but the audio is not so clear. It is like.
Yeah, I have some trouble with my internet right now. I don't know why.
Yes, I think it is the internet because I saw some lag on the screen, but like 15 minutes ago. No, it is not so stable, right?
Yeah, I have some problems.
But just today, because in the previous classes we have normal. Yeah, but I can hear you. Okay. Yes.
Okay, thanks. Teacher, thank you.
Okay. Thanks so much, Diego. We're going now with Claudita. And
personal information is social media.
Okay. Good. Okay. This is an internet speech. So if you see here, I'm going to play it again. Lo voy a reproducir de nuevo para que ustedes puedan escuchar la pronunciación de esta persona, que sí es un poquito rápida. Y hay palabras que la dice como que más linkeadas, ¿verdad? Como más unidas. Listen. Tenemos acá. Okay.
E-learning speech. with the help of the internet, purchasing products online has become very popular among people. All the banking and financial transactions can be sent and can receive money with the internet's help. But with all the benefits, the internet has disadvantages as well. The disadvantages include the leaking of data and personal information. Social media can also create disturbances through malicious content.
Okay, so the main objective of this activity, el objetivo principal de esta actividad, is that you can identify different words, okay? That's the most important point in here. It is not necessary for you to understand every single word in this audio, but of course, it is important to have like a clear idea about what the content is about. Si captan un par de palabras, pueden tener una idea, un contexto de qué se trata. Okay, because you listen internet, those are keywords, son palabras claves. Internet, purchasing products, of course. I consider that you heard that. Ustedes sí escucharon eso. Also, financial transactions, benefits, okay. Also, content, and that's it, okay. Entonces, eso es verdad. Que habla this, talks, or it's about advantages and disadvantages about internet, ¿verdad? Ventajas y desventajas. Something that, well, there are some things that are good. For example, there are transactions nowadays and they can receive money, okay, with the internet's help. But with all the benefits, the internet has disadvantages. A eso se refiere que también hay desventajas. Similar as we were talking at the beginning of the class about the difference between businesses nowadays in comparison to the businesses 50 years ago, ¿verdad? Si comparamos los negocios de ahora 50 años atrás, pues, pues similar, okay? So we're going to have different activities like this. So for you to have like a different kind of audios, ¿verdad? Listening, ya solo nos quedan, we have 12 minutes, 12 minutos y terminamos. Pero sí, lo que yo quiero es darle diferentes tipos de actividades para que tengan pues una idea pues de cómo mejorar, más bien mejorar nuestro audio, ¿verdad? Que vean que no es tan complicado. Ok.
That is great, great teacher. I'm very thankful to you.
Ok.
Because yes. You are doing that.
Ok, it's a pleasure for me, Diego. I consider that sometimes one of the limitations that we as students, hablo también como estudiante, that we have had, que hemos tenido, is that we only listen to the teacher's pronunciation. And that's not so healthy, no es saludable. Because if you travel or if you find, you meet another person, it's going to be a little bit difficult if you're not accustomed to different kinds of accents. ¿Verdad? Difícil cuando no estamos acostumbrados a diferentes tipos de acentos. So, yeah, so tomorrow.
Very important.
Yes, of course. Okay, you're welcome, my friend.
Thank you so much, teacher.
It's a pleasure, Diego. Now let's go with don't, doesn't exercise. This is quite easy. Esto es bastante fácil. Okay, so Susie is going to be the first one. And so remember, use don't or doesn't because we are talking in this activity about negative sentences. Of course, remember that doesn't, it is used for third person. Okay, and don't for the rest of the personal pronouns. Okay, Susie, como estás activada, I'm going to give you two sentences, okay?
Qué justo.
Yes, it's fair.
Rebecca doesn't drink coffee.
Okay, we... Rebecca doesn't drink coffee.
¿Sigo?
Yes.
We don't wear jeans.
We don't wear.
We don't wear jeans.
We don't wear jeans. Wear es usar, vestir, ¿verdad? Pero cuando usa nuestro corazón es use, es diferente, ¿ok? So nice, we're going with Claudita, que se está recordando de alguien. Ok, Claudita, pick one and then we go with Helen.
Number three.
Ok. They,
this boy. This boy doesn't play golf.
Ok, this, we are talking about plural. And remember, when we have plural, we use...
Don't play golf.
Yeah, these boys don't play golf. Okay. Si dijéramos the boy, sería diferente. Okay. So these boys. Now we go with Marlon and then Claudia.
I don't teach Italian.
Okay, you don't teach Italian. Claudia de Indiana.
Your brother don't smile.
Smile, smile.
Smile.
Okay, estamos hablando de, we are talking about a boy. Entonces puede ser, usada, podemos utilizar un he aquí. So it's third person. Y para las terceras personas, Claudia, ¿qué? Doesn't. Your brother doesn't smile. Okay, now Diana, and we go with Carmen.
My mother doesn't like rats.
Yeah, I think nobody. Creo que nadie le gusta. Okay, nice. Carmen.
This car doesn't run fast.
Yes, doesn't run fast. Yes, this car. Okay. And Helen, what about this? Helen, you can do it.
They don't go to the cinema.
Yeah, they don't go to the cinema. Of course it is. So 8 minutes. 8 minutos y terminamos. Okay, we continue with more and more and more. So we go now with Diego and then Alex. Pick one.
Okay. This man doesn't smoke.
Yes, poor of him. Well, that's positive as well. And we have also Alex, right? Alex, and then we go with Dora.
You don't have a car.
Okay, you don't have a car, of course. Dorita, and then we go with Kevin.
They don't speak English.
They don't speak, Dorita.
They don't speak English.
Yes, that's it. That's a suena como locutora. Okay, Kevin, Carla.
I don't like swimming.
Okay, I don't like swimming. Okay, that's it. Carla, then Christian.
Penguins don't flee.
Vaya. Como es un animal, podemos utilizar it. ¿Verdad? Entonces es tercera persona. Uh-huh. Entonces no utilizamos don, sino que vamos a utilizar, Carla.
Vieja.
Doesn't. Ajá. A penguin doesn't fly. Okay. Thank you. Okay, we go with Christian, right? And Mercy.
It doesn't rain in summer.
Perfect, Christian. Mercy, and then we go with Edgar.
Snail doesn't wear clothes.
Yes, a snail. Snail.
A snail.
Doesn't wear clothes. Cabal, mira en Caribe. Ahí anda, chulón. Okay, that's it. No usa ropa. And who's next? Who's next? Andrea. No. Or Edgar. Edgar, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then Andrea.
And primero. We don't go by train.
By train. By train, of course. And Andrea?
Crocodiles doesn't live in the sea.
Okay, we're talking, Andreita, about...
Crocodiles.
Plural. Así que para lo... Si dijéramos crocodile, yes. Sería doesn't. Pero como es crocodiles...
Aunque sea tercera persona.
No es tercera persona porque tenemos dos. Si fuera solo este cocodrilo, sí, puede ser tercera persona, igual que este pingüino, igual que este chico, igual que este caracol. Entonces aquí vamos a utilizar. Andreita, te has juntado con Diana, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad que te has juntado a la salida? Tuvieron after. Okay.
Es que hoy descansamos, por eso.
Okay, that explains a lot. Eso explains amistades. Okay, we're about to finish. We have only 4 minutes. Solo tenemos 4 minutos. Así que solo vamos a ver una short, a really brief conversation. Una conversación breve, que es la primera. So I will need the participation of some of you. So Mercy is going to... You go with line number one. Solo vamos por líneas. Mercy and then Kevin. Okay?
Hello, can I get your name?
Okay, Kevin.
Yes, my name is Tom Wilson.
Thank you. Diana here and Andrea.
Yes. No, great. Great. And can I see your ID?
Sure. Andrea?
Sure. Here is it.
Here is it. Okay. Okay. Now here we have Carla. And it's going to be Edgar.
Thank you. Can you sign here?
Ah, can you sign here? Puedes firmar. Porque cuando decimos sin, es cantar. Pero aquí la G va antes y sign significa firmar. Es como signo. Ok, signo o firma. Ok, Carla. Sería okay. Sign. Ok.
Sign.
Yes, sign. Ok, eso significa firma o señal, ¿verdad? O algo así. Edgar. Yeah, sería certainly, certainly, certainly. Thank you. Okay, and now we go, we are about to finish. So, Dorita, here, man, and we go with Marlon with the second.
Hello. Hello, can I take your order?
Good, Ken. Can I take, porque te escuchaste bien europea. Okay, Ken, thank you. Marlon, yes.
Yes. Can I get the chicken sandwich?
Okay, good. Now we go with Carmen. Certainly, certainly. And then we're having Claudia. Yes.
¿Qué es certamente?
Sorry?
¿Qué es certamente?
Ciertamente.
Ah, okay. Certainly. And can I get you something to drink?
Claudia?
Yes. Can I get a diet? Así.
Diet.
A diet. Diet soda, please.
Yes. Can I get? Can? Si se dan cuenta, aquí utilizamos mucho el can, ¿verdad? Para no decir can. Can. Ok. Vamos con Shore y aquí me va a ayudar Cristian. Y me va a ayudar Edgar aquí en Yes.
Sure.
Sure.
Sure. Anytime else, can I interest you in sometime on the sign?
Okay. Side. Okay, good. Edgar, yes.
Yes, can I get some fries with that?
Yes, fries with that. Thank you, Claudita, of course. And Helen, no.
Of course, anything else?
Helen,
no. No, they will do.
Okay, thank you. I'm going to check the attendance and we finish, okay? So, Ana Mercedes.
Present.
Nice. And Andrea.
Hi, teacher.
Oh. And Carmen.
Present.
Thank you. Claudia.
Present.
Okay, Claudita.
I'm here.
You're there. Christian.
Present.
Thank you. Alex. Alex, oh well. Diana?
Present.
Nice. Diego?
Present.
Okay, thank you. Present. Dora? Okay, Alex. Present. Thank you. Okay, good. Nice. Edgar?
Present.
Good. Helen? Not here. Yes. Present. Yes, yes, I'm sorry. Te confundí con otro. Okay, Carla?
Present.
Thank you. Kelvin? No, Kevin.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Marlon?
Present.
Nice. And Susie?
Present.
Okay. Goodbye, my friend. Have a good night. Buenas noches. Vayan a descansar. See you.
Good night, everybody.
Goodbye.
Tomorrow.
Andrea, se me queda. Dianita, ya no sigas. Okay. Mm-hmm. Confesate, mujer.
Okay, teacher, yo tengo una pregunta.
Pues, pero
siempre me cuesta cuando, digamos que usted nos manda las tareas y yo tengo que hacer, obviamente contestarlas, va, pero me cuesta cuando voy a hablar en pasado y en futuro.
Por ejemplo, la de la primera, de la compañía.
Ajá. Digamos que no sé cómo vaya, porque yo tenía entendido que para hacer el verbo en pasado se le agrega ed.
Sí, es regular. No. Sí, es regular. Aquí.
Y en futuro es ing, parece.
Vale, te voy a dar una mini clase de esto, ¿viste? Entradito. Permíteme. Vale. Acá, digamos, tenemos esto. Sí, en este caso, por ejemplo, para los verbos, tenemos dos tipos de verbos, ¿verdad? Tenemos los regulares y tenemos los irregulares. Para los verbos, en este caso, que son regulares e irregulares, tenemos, por ejemplo, acá. Por ejemplo, play, ¿verdad? Es un verbo regular. En pasado se dice play. Ahora tenemos los irregulares, que por ejemplo, go, se dice went. ¿Sí estamos ahí?
Sí.
Ok, vale. Ahora, vamos ahorita a trabajar primero el pasado. De ahí vamos al futuro. Ok. Vaya, contame algo que vos haces. Tell me a routine, something that you do during the day. Algo que haces durante la semana. Cualquier cosa. En presente.
I go to work.
Ok. Otra, aparte de esa. Bueno, I go to work. ¿La querés poner? ¿Cómo podríamos decir? Fui a trabajar la semana pasada. Sería I.
Went.
¿Qué más?
I went. Ya no sería.
No, lo mismo.
I went to work.
No te compliques, es lo mismo. Ahora, ¿cómo decimos la semana pasada?
Past week. No.
Casi, me llega porque inventás, pero no.
Ay, last week.
Esto sí es importante que lo noten. Yesterday. The day before yesterday. No, vamos a poner así. Last week. And podemos decir last week. Mira, este last week es la vieja confiable. Last Monday. Last weekend, last month. Esto sí, normalmente hablamos de cuestiones un poquito personales. Ok, ahora vamos con otro que es importante. One year ago. Eso significa hace un año. Uh-huh. Eso es súper importante. Five years ago, hace 5 años. ¿Ok? Ahora,
sí.
Tenemos otros verbos. Vamos con los irregulares, que son los que más cuestan. Have, en pasado, ¿cómo se dice?
Es has.
No, me gusta que inventes, pero no me gusta. Ah, Andreita. Ya ves por qué no le creo a las mujeres. Vaya, entonces, me faltó el número. Ok, ahora, ¿cómo decimos? Decir que tenés un perro.
I have dog, one dog.
I have a dog, muy bien. ¿Cómo podemos decir yo tuve un perro hace 10 años?
I have a dog No le pongo más, solo 10 years ahí, ago.
Ahí está, ahí está. Sí, es que no te compliques, Andreita. Busca, seguí tu, es que bueno, seguí tu corazón. No seguí tu corazón. Oíme.
No sé qué le pasa.
Ajá, ajá. Mira, el inglés no es complicado. De hecho, tiene menos palabras que el español. Ya no te compliques. Vos decís tu idea como vos consideres. Ahora, digamos que querías hablar de la empresa en pasado. ¿Qué querías decir? Por ejemplo, 50 years ago, hace 50 años, the payment was by cash. Y estás diciendo, hace 50 años el pago era
en efectivo.
En efectivo, otra vez. Years ago, mira, y así puedes generar tus opiniones.
Uh-huh.
50 years ago, the internet didn't exist. Aunque fíjate que tus ideas me gustan bastante, fíjate, pero puedes comenzar desde una idea simple y de ahí la vas adornando. Eso te recomiendo.
Vaya.
Ok, vale, ya tenemos esto. Vamos con el futuro ahorita, que todavía nos quedan unos 2 minutos. Para el futuro, bueno, preguntas con respecto a esto.
Uh-uh. Ahí ¿no? voy, ya la agarré.
Ya ves, no, pues sí, me recomiendo. Ok. Future, lo podemos utilizar con will o con going to.
Ajá, eso.
Ahora. Esta es más fácil. A mí me gusta bastante este. Porque cuando utilizamos el will, eso se vuelve súper facilísimo. Porque solo le pones, por ejemplo, vaya, el del trabajo, mira. I will work tomorrow. Fácil. Otro, I will go to the cinema next week. Y fácil.
Uh-huh.
Le pones solo I will, es como que si fuera presente. I work. I go. ¿Te das cuenta? Pero sí. Lo que ayuda son estas frases, que son estas mismas frases que te acabo de dar acá. Mira. Estas frases te ayudan a que la oración tenga más sentido. ¿Ok? Ahora, ¿cuál es la diferencia con el going to? I am going to work. ¿Cuál es la diferencia del going to? Es que el going to es más seguro. El going to es algo que va a pasar. Tenés muchos. Estás segura de que va a pasar. En cambio, el will es para hacer planes. Por ejemplo, I will be married. Next year me voy a casar el otro año. No, en 5 años, digamos. I will marry in 5 years. Me voy a casar en 5 años. Entonces, no es muy seguro. No es como que digas, I'm going to get married next month. El otro mes te vas a casar y es segura, a menos que el hombre se te escape con otra. De ahí estás segura. Ahora, lo que sí te va a ayudar son las frases. Por ejemplo, tomorrow, next week.
Uh-huh.
Y así, ya te las puedes.
Sí.
¿Verdad que ya te las puedes? ¿Ves? Next year. O podemos decir in 5 years. Ya.
Sí.
Uh-huh. Entonces, esto sería lo del futuro. Mira, explicado de una manera bien corta, Andreita. Ajá. Sí,
sí, hoy sí.
Vale. ¿Verdad? Uh-huh. Entonces, sería más que todo para que tengamos una idea. Esto no es un tema que me toque hablarlo durante este módulo, fíjate. Me gustaría, porque cuando abarcas estos temas, después los estudiantes pueden opinar de manera más enriquecida. Si te das cuenta, ahora estamos como bien limitados y hoy como que medio batallando con eso, porque en este módulo tienen que platicar más. Bueno, ese es mi objetivo, que ustedes hablen más, ¿verdad? Entonces, si te das cuenta, si te notas, las preguntas que les hago son diferentes a las del módulo pasado. ¿Verdad? Sí. Que notas que son un poquito más complicaditas.
Sí.
O les hacen, pero de eso se trata, porque si estamos con lo mismo, no van a avanzar.
Ah, vaya.
Entonces, como vos creas, vos dale, ¿oíste? Inténtalo y ahí vamos a ir mejorando. Me gustaría poder, voy a ver si puedo tocar ciertos temas como esos, ¿oíste?
Mire, fíjese que a mí un amigo me mandó un listado de verbos, pero no sé cómo enseñárselo, no sé si se lo mando a WhatsApp.
Mándamelo a WhatsApp y yo mañana veo y me decís que cuál es tu duda y todo eso, ¿oíste? Y ahí voy a tomarme un rato de la mañana para...
Va, vaya.
¿Oíste, Andreita?
Sí, sí, porque aquí me dice, está el cuadro, va, está presente, pasado, participio, progresivo y meaning, no sé qué significa.
Meaning es significado.
Meaning. Sí.
Ah, algunos cuadros de esos aparecen como Spanish, otros aparecen como meaning. Meaning es significado. Es como cuando te preguntan, Andrea, what's the meaning of rainy? Te estoy preguntando cuál es el significado de rainy. Ya, por eso, meaning es significado. Cuando te preguntan, what's the meaning of actually, what's the meaning of currently, es eso. Pero mira, no te enfoques en las otras columnas, enfócate en presente. Bueno, mañana te voy a decir, ¿verdad?
Vaya.
Las demás columnas poco a poco las vas a ir viendo, porque sí, en los demás módulos sí se ven todos esos.
Ah, va.
Y no cuesta, sí. De verdad, no te digo, no te lo digo por
perdón.
De verdad. Firulais.
Sí, ahí está.
Va, Enrique, okay. Entonces terminamos. Espero que haya sido de ayuda y por lo menos ya tenés como un panorama algo claro. ¿Sí tomaste captura o anotaste?
Anoté.
Va. Bueno, te me cuidas entonces.
Ok, teacher. Bye.
Nos vemos.
Thank you.
Bye. You're welcome.